This time, we're looking for an angle in this particular example, and the angle is the angle C down here, or you could call it ACB. Now, that's what we're looking for. Let's have a look at the formula. It's the same formula as before, except the C, the angle, is in the subject on the left-hand side. So we have cos C, the angle, right over here that we're looking for, equals A squared plus B squared minus C squared all over 2AB. Now, it's fantastic news to get three sides, no angles, because there's no other rule you can use. The only tool you can use, the only technique, is cosine rule, and this is it here. So let's do the first step and label on the diagram, displayed right over here, and then substitute into the formula and then come up with the angle C. So let's take it in the first step. First step is to label, so let's have a look here. We're looking for the angle C down here, and directly opposite, right up there, is the little c. That's the length, and that is 4. Now, over here, capital A, which is the angle, that's opposite to 5. And again, the 7, that's going to be little b, opposite the big angle, capital B. And remember down here, that's going to be little a. So we got all the little a's and b's labeled on there. We have the angles already labeled. All we got to do is drag and drop that into the formula, the cos rule formula, and find the angle C. Now, let's put the values in. So first off, we have cos C, which is what we're looking for, and that equals A squared. Now let's go to A squared. That's down here as 5 we labeled. Little a equals 5. So let's put that in. 5 squared plus little b. Let's have a look at little b. It goes from big B to little b. That's going to be 7, yeah? Minus, directly opposite the angle we're looking for, directly opposite that length there, is 4. So that's going to be 4 squared, as the formula indicates. Now, underneath we have 2 times a times b, so that's going to be 2 times 5 times 7. Okay, that's all the values from there. Substitute into the formula. Let's work it out. So, cos C equals 5 squared plus 7 squared minus 4 squared, all in the calculator. That will give you a grand total of 58 all over 2 times 5 times 7. That's going to give us 70. Okay, so cos C equals 58 divided by 70. You know it's going to be a decimal. It's going to be 0.5. Now, cos C equals that. What do we do to get the angle? We've got to shift cos on both sides. So we shift cos here, we'll be left just with the C. So shift cos 0.8286 gives us an angle of 34 degrees and 3 minutes after you press shift DMS or shift degrees minutes seconds.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.